Hi friends, in today's short tutorial we'll be looking at how you can use variables to create dynamic prototypes in Figma. At the end of this tutorial you'll have a simple prototype like this where you have a list of chocolates and then you can click to add them to your cart, and as you add them you have the total count of your truffles. Then you also have the total cost, and it doesn't matter which truffle you click, and we'll be limiting it to 3 truffles only per truffle. I'll get into why a little bit later, but essentially you can click on any truffle and it will calculate it down here. And thankfully, because of the variables, we'll be able to accomplish this with just a couple of prototype links. So here I have a worksheet file, and currently if we preview, I just have this list here. I have all the components, but I can't click or interact with this in any way. And in terms of the file itself, we have this iPhone frame here, and then we have the images. Then we have a component for our single list item. And so the reason I will be limiting it to 3 is because if I wanted to add an ability to choose an infinite amount of truffles, I'd have had to create a separate mode for each of the truffles. And if you are on Figma's like education or pro or organization plan, you only have access to 4 modes. So I would have only been able to do that for 4 of these. That's why I'm limiting to just being able to pick 3. All right, the first thing that I'm going to do is we're going to go into local variables. We'll create our first variable, which is going to be a number. And this number is going to be a cost per truffle. We can set it to 3 now, but we can change it later. Then the second number is going to be total truffles, which will be 0. And then total cost, which is also going to be 0. Now what we need to do is we're going to bind these variables to our components. The first one that we're going to do is for our button here. Here it just says 0 truffles, but this 0 is not bound to anything. What we're going to do is in the properties panel, you're going to go to this variable icon here. You'll click it, and this one will be total truffles. So it didn't change because I already had 0 here and the variable is also 0. But if we were to go into our local variables and change this to like 8, you would see that the variable would update. So let's change it back to 0. And then the next thing I'm going to do is we'll take this total cost and we'll update it to total cost. So you see it changed to 0. I don't think I can. Yeah, like if I try to add the cents here, it just defaults back to 0. So this is our button. And then the last thing that we would need to do in terms of variable binding is we'll go to this cost per truffle, and then you can click this icon to select all of the matching layers. From here, we're going to once again click this icon and we'll do cost per truffle. Again, if you'll go to local variables and change it to like 5, you'll see this displayed here. Now what we're going to do is we're going to add a couple of interactions to this list item component, and currently we don't have anything. First, what I'm going to do is on this plus here, we'll create an interaction going to the second variant. For the interaction type, we'll change it to smart animate, and we can leave it at 300 milliseconds. Then I'm going to do the same thing for the other ones, and we're going to do the other way around. So if you click minus, it's just going to go in the other direction. And now we can preview what we currently have. So now I can click and you can see that it changes. But what's currently not happening is that we're not adding anything up. What we're going to do now is I'm going to select all the interactions that increment the amount of truffles. And from here, we're going to add an action. This first action is going to be set variable. For the set variable, we're going to do total truffles and we're going to increment it by 1. So if initially we had 0 truffles, then the first time you click it, it's going to increment it by 1, 0 plus 1 is 1, and etc. Let's once again preview what we have. So now you see when I click plus, we can now see the total number of truffles in the button here. But then when I decrease, nothing happens. And we also don't see the total cost for all the truffles in our bag. So what we're going to do first is once again, I'm going to select all of the interactions. Again, we're just doing the incrementing ones first. I'll add another action. It's also going to be to set variable. And this one is going to be total cost equals to total cost plus cost per truffle. Now when you click, you should see the total amount of truffles and the total cost. And once again, we haven't set anything for when you're removing truffles from your bag. So this would be our last step. We're going to select all the interactions. Our first variable is going to be total truffles minus one. And then our second variable is going to be total cost subtract cost per variable. Now, when we return back to the prototype, we should be able to count the total amount of truffles as you add them. We should see the cost. Then once you start removing them, you should also see both the cost and the total amount of truffles going down. Something that's very convenient about this is, let's say we did want to change our cost per truffle to 4. And the only place where I would need to change that is in my variable collection. Now, when I return to the prototype, you can see that it's reflected in our cost per item. And then when I add it, you can see that it's also reflected in the total cost. Anyway, that's really it. I do want to give a shout out to the chocolate company where I got all the like images and all these fun names from. And if you do find this layout overall familiar, I did get it from Uber Eats. I've always really admired how their buttons are very descriptive and contain information about your order. So I wanted to use that in this prototype. I will link the worksheet, so the file that's just empty and doesn't have any prototype interactions, that just has the components and this iPhone frame, and I'll add the link to the finished file. But again, if you're learning variables, I do suggest you try out the blank worksheet first, and then if you want to take a peek at the finished file, you do that afterwards. Aside from that, please let me know if you have any questions, and until next time, bye-bye.